Brother Ali from Canada, I captured the last part of your question, which is creating websites and maintaining websites for restaurants that serve alcohol. Let me say, for instance, I'm creating a website for Red Lobster, Fridays Inn, or whatever. What happens is, in the subtitles, or in one of the categories, the restaurant says that it serves the finest quality of different types of wine or beer, and our bar has this and this and that. Doesn't it? Yes, it does. You can't. وَلَا تَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْإِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ. And do not assist one another in committing sins or transgression. And this ayah, also, we need a whole episode to speak about it and its implications with regards to what's going on, whether in Egypt, in Syria, or anywhere in the world. While some people are reclining on their couches, drinking their juice, and enjoying their nuts, and watching the news, and saying these people deserve, because they're fanatic, extremists, or terrorists, okay, believing only what they hear. So inshallah, we'll be tackling this in very details. But now, so creating any website which would serve the purpose of propagating anything that is haram is accordingly haram. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, إِنَّ اللَّهَ إِذَا حَرَّمَ شَيْئًا حَرَّمَ ثَمَنَهُ. If Allah forbids anything, then its price is also forbidden. Its price is also forbidden. He's asking about a statement which says if two Muslims fight, then both will go to hell and so on. The hadith is a sound hadith in which Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا الْتَقَى الْمُسْلِمَانِ بِسَيْفَيْهِمَا فَالْقَاتِلُ وَالْمَقْتُولُ فِي النَّارِ. قُلْنَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ هَذَا الْقَاتِلُ فَمَا بَالُ الْمَقْتُولِ. قَالْ فَإِنَّهُ كَانَ حَرِيصًا عَلَى قَتْلِ صَاحِبِهِ. This is absolutely true. If two Muslims happen to fight against each other with their swords or any weapons or any means of killing, then both, and as a result of that, one of them is dead, then both of them will enter the fire of hell. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. The murderer and the murdered one. So they said, Ya Rasulullah, it is obvious that the murderer deserves to go to hell. What about the one who's murdered? He said he too was very keen to kill his opponent, or actually his brother. This is in the case of both are transgressing. But I explained this hadith in Riyadh al-Salihin, the program of Guardians of the Pious. And I said, for innocence, there is another hadith. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to somebody, he said, Ya Rasulullah, what if somebody came to rob me? He said, you should repel him and defend yourself. He said, what if I fight against him? What if I kill him? He said, he will go to hell and you will not. He said, what if he kills me? He said, you will go to heaven and he will go to hell. Why? Because you have the right, you're defending yourself, you're defending your property, you're defending your deen, you're defending your family members. So this is a different case. But two people fighting for dunya, for their personal ego and carrying the swords, that's a different issue. Both of them are in a terrible condition. But somebody is oppressed and somebody is an oppressor. So I defend myself. By any mean, I'm trying to save my life. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to this companion, if you kill him, he will go to hell because he is a transgressor. And you are not. And he said, if you get killed, then you will be in paradise. This is the hadith in order to understand the earlier one in the light of this hadith and others. I don't remember exactly in which episode or the episode number, but it has been explained in the course of Sharh Riyadh al-Salihin. Insha'Allah Azza Jal, that will be our regular time until a further notice. And you have a homework. Every Muslim has a homework and a duty towards his fellow Muslim brothers and sisters. This is what the secular world is trying to do, which is to disconnect the ummah from each other. And we will do the opposite, inshallah. We care about our brothers and sisters in Burma, in Afghanistan, in Pakistan, in Kashmir, in Egypt, in Syria, in Palestine. This is all happening in order to